Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies. And with all of the key programming videos that we've been doing, so many of you have been asking questions about the Smart Pro pricing. There's a lot of information out there and it's hard to quite understand and put all the puzzle pieces together. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do in this video. Let's get started. Now I'm going to be going over the three main ways that you can use the Smart Pro. There's really four. I'll be covering that at the very end here. But what I'm not going to be talking about is ways that you can purchase the machine. And the reason for that is over the past few years that the Smart Pro has been out, there's been all sorts of different options to buy the machine, to trade a older machine in for the Smart Pro. And so I want to make sure that I figure if you can understand the options really well, you'll be able to really make a good informed decision for your business on what option would be right for you. But feel free to ask questions in the notes below, or you can always send us an email or give us a call and we can go over the current pricing available. Now, the three ways that you can use the Smart Pro is going to be by purchasing software for the machine, by purchasing tokens for the machine, or by purchasing something called a UTP. Let's go ahead and get started with the software. Now, if you were to just purchase the Smart Pro and you want to own your software, meaning you're not going to have to pay any maintenance fees or subscriptions, you just want to buy the software, you want to own it, and you want to use it free of charge for as long as you choose to. Now, you can do that with the Smart Pro, okay? Now, there's currently, at the timing of this video, there's currently 71 loads of software, all right? Meaning that there's 71 individual pieces of software that you can purchase and put on the machine. Now, the pricing for the software is gonna range between $499 up to $799. So if you do some quick math and you were to just buy the software individually, well, you're looking at about $35,000 to purchase all the software individually. Now, there are packages available where you can buy big groups of software for much less. However, the reason I want to point out this $35 amount is because, like, let's say you start right now and you just want to just get like Ford software. Well, over time, you're like, maybe I want to add Honda software, or I want to add Chrysler software, whatever it might be. Going down that road, and if that's something that you think that sounds like something you might do, well, over the long term, well, as the years go on, that amount can get pretty expensive. Who is buying software right for? Okay, now I would say the best example I could give you of buying a Smart Pro and then just putting software on it that you want to own, okay, is going to be that if you're really heavy into, let's say, Chrysler Dodge Jeep, and you know that 99% of the stuff that you're going to be programming is just going to be Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Well, there's not really a reason to maybe want to just only do tokens or only do like a UTP. By just doing the software, you can buy it once and you can own it. And then as the new software comes out for Chrysler Dodge Jeep, you can just purchase that as you see fit. So that would be probably the best example I could give you of why you would just want to just purchase software. Now your next option is to purchase tokens. Now tokens, if there's one thing with advanced diagnostics that gets people fired up, it's tokens, right? And I think as a whole, though, the term token doesn't necessarily fit very well with what it's actually accomplishing, right? Now, there's not like a token, a physical token that you were to like pop in the machine to use it like an arcade game. It's a virtual token, and essentially is what a token represents is programming a vehicle. Right, so for the most part, about, let's say, 85% of the time, when you program a vehicle, it's going to require one token. Now, there are a few examples. Like I said, that's 85% of the time that on certain vehicles, when you read the skim code, like on a Chrysler, and you have to read that code, it doesn't bypass it. Well, that's gonna cost you a token. And then when you actually successfully program the vehicle, that's also going to charge you a token. So there are a few of those examples, but is what you wanna look at is, it's gonna cost me X amount per vehicle to program, okay? That's really what a token is. Now, let's talk about the pricing at this time. Now, the pricing could change, but the principles is behind the pricing will always kind of be the same, okay? And that is, you can buy a 10-pack of tokens, but that makes each token $40 a piece. Now, the next option is to buy a 25-pack of tokens, and that is currently $33 a piece. So you buy 25 tokens at $33 a piece. Now, when you buy the 50 pack of tokens, that pricing is going to go down to $27 a piece. And last but not least, if you buy the 250 pack of tokens, it's going to bring the price down to $13 a piece, which is much more reasonable in today's competitive market. Now, the reason you would want to buy tokens, and from my perspective, okay, is the use factor. That's gonna really dictate where you're going to land. And if you land in the wrong spot, for example, you decide just to buy 10 packs of tokens and it costs you $40 to $80 per vehicle to program, well, that's gonna make you pretty unhappy over time, because that's a lot of money per vehicle if you're doing, you know, 50 or 70 a year. But to get back to my original point here, is that if you're programming, you know, 50, 75 vehicles a year, really considering going with a token option, like a 50 or even better, a 250 pack, that's gonna kind of be your sweet spot there. Now make sure you stick around to the end, because I'm gonna be going over a hybrid option that really starts to make a lot more sense when it comes to tokens. Now I wanna talk about my favorite part of the Smart Pro, which is the UTP, which stands for Unlimited Token Plan, which means you have unlimited use of the machine for the time set. And essentially, unlimited token plan, a UTP, is essentially a SaaS, which is a software as a service. And kind of the best example I can come up with to compare it to would be like your cell phone, right? So you have to purchase your cell phone, and then you have to pay every month to use it, essentially, right? If you wanna be able to make phone calls or have internet access or 4G or 5G access, you have to pay that monthly fee for that. The good part about that is that when new software comes available, you can download that right onto the machine and you can use it. There's no extra fee because you're paying for a service, a software as a service. Now there's three different options you can choose with the UTP. The first one is gonna be your monthly plan, meaning you have to sign up, just like your cell phone, you have to sign up for X amount of time, like let's just say a year at a time. And you sign up for that year at a time and you agree to pay $320 a month, all right? The next option is gonna be your yearly UTP, which is $3,200 all at once. So you just have one charge per year for $3,200. Now, if we break that down per month, that's gonna break it down to $267, or technically a little less, but let's just say $267 a month. Now, if you can budget and save and do that right, I mean, the savings between the monthly and the yearly is quite significant, and it's something I highly, highly recommend you can do if you can afford it. Now the third option here is gonna be the 24-hour pass. And this will make more sense here in a few moments when I get into the hybrid options of the machine. But essentially, you buy a 5-pack of UTP 24-hour passes for, right now it's $225, and which comes out to $45 per 24 hours. By now, you might be wondering, man, that's a lot of different options. Why is there so many available? And what's this hybrid option you're talking about? Glad you asked. Let's talk about it. So, something that can make sense for a lot of Smart Pro users is the hybrid feature. And what do I mean by that? Is what I mean is that, like, let's say you bought all of the Ford software. Okay, so you have all the Ford programming software. However, now and then, you know, you do some GM, right? But you don't have any of the GM software and you don't do enough to justify purchasing outright the software for GM. Well, in that case, you can just buy tokens. So let's say you buy a 50 pack of tokens, and at that point, anytime you use you program a Ford, it doesn't cost you any tokens because you own the software. However, when that GM comes in and you need to program it, well, that's going to use one of the tokens. So that's going to allow you flexibility based on what you're trying to accomplish and what your business needs are. Now, what's even more exciting about the hybrid process is you can also purchase those 24-hour UTP passes that I was just talking about. So let's say you had all those Ford softwares that you owned outright. However, one day came and all of a sudden you have 30 vehicles that you need to program that are all different makes and models, okay? Well, you can do the Fords, but you don't have any ability to do anything else. Or let's say you didn't have, you know, any software and all you have is you buy 50 packs of tokens. Well, in one day to burn up, you know, 25, 35 of those, I mean, that's not really wise due to the cost of the token. So what you can in either one of these scenarios is you can purchase a 24 hour UTP pass. Now you have to purchase those in packs of five, right? But if you break it down at the current time of this video, about $45 per 24 hours. So what it's going to allow you to do is to not burn up your tokens if you have them, or if you just have software and you don't have enough software to do everything you need to do, it doesn't matter. You can just get that 24 hour pass for that $45 and you can program all of them. And that's a great, great option if you're not using just the standard UTP plan. So those are the three options available for the Smart Pro. Well, really four if you include the hybrid options as well. Now, the big question is what do I recommend? What do I think you should do? If you're gonna be just doing $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, maybe $10,000 a year in key programming, that's great, right? We all have to get started and build up the business. Well, that makes the Smart Pro super, super expensive, right, on a per use basis. And so I think in those type of situations, and I've been pretty open about this, I really think that there's some good entry level machines that you can use that really make sense if that's all the programming that you're gonna be doing for now. Now, however, if you're doing $25,000, $50,000, $100,000+ a year of key programming, getting the Smart Pro with the yearly or monthly UTP is really the sweet spot because the cost per vehicle is gonna be super low. It's really gonna allow you to capitalize on the profits available for key programming. Purchasing software by itself in today's environment that we live in is just probably not the best option outside of a very small percentage of people. And the reason why is the amount of technology that's coming into these keys, into the cars, and the constant updating and the new software that's coming out. For example, I think at the peak of AD's software output in a year was right around 12, 13 different programs. So if you're paying $500 to $800 a piece for those, that's super expensive. Right? And then at the same time, you know, if when it comes to tokens, you know, honestly, I really don't like to see anyone using a $40 token, right? That's hard. I mean, that takes a lot of money off the table for you. And so that's why I think the sweet spot, in my opinion, is getting that UTP plan. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I'd love to know what type of questions you have in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Well, I really hope that shed some light as a software as a service. You know, another example, kind of like a cell phone, would also be like Netflix, right? Now, back in the day, if you loved a TV show, you would have to wait, you know, week by week to watch each episode, or you could buy, you know, the DVD collection for quite a bit amount of money. Where nowadays, with companies like Netflix out there, which is a software as a service, you just pay a monthly fee, and next thing you know, the next episode of, or the next season of Stranger Things comes out, and you stay up all night watching it. I may or may not have done that. No, let me redo that a little bit here. Okay. No. Where now with companies like Netflix, which is a software as a service, you can, when a new season gets on, you can just watch the whole thing. I may or may not have done that with Stranger Things.
No, I gotta deliver that, right? It's good though.
Watch all of the episodes, stay up till 2 or 3 in the morning because you are just so excited to watch all the episodes. Well, I really hope that the Stranger Things. Since you just watched this video, I'm guessing that you work with locks and keys. And to us at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss. And we wanna hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, join the conversation and comment on our posts and videos and include the hashtag lockboss. It's free to enter this giveaway. And every Tuesday, we're gonna pick 5 winners from the previous week and hook you up with all sorts of prizes, including gear, tools, supplies. We might even send you a key machine or buy you lunch. So if you're a lock boss, join us every week to learn, grow, and win. Stranger Things.